Hi, my name is Todd Houlihan. I'm the director of Olympus' International Mining Group. This video is the first in a series designed to support you plan and implement a portable Xrf program for testing all the types of samples we might encounter for geochemical and environmental applications. We intend to cover everything you need to know to be successful with your portable Xrf. Portable Xrf analyzers start to display the chemistry of a sample on the screen of the instrument within 2 seconds of the start of a test. But typical test times range from between 20 seconds to 2 minutes. The data can then be downloaded into spreadsheets, databases, or as PDF reports quickly and seamlessly. The analyzers themselves are very easy to use, and most people get up and running within half a day of training. But there are some aspects of using portable XRFs for geochemical applications that can compromise the value of the data produced. It's these aspects that we want to cover in this video series. The goal is to ensure everyone using an analyzer knows at least some basic concepts to help them be able to generate data from a portable XRF that could be considered fit for purpose. So what are we going to cover? Well, these are the things we feel are worthy of individual video tutorials in their own right. Setting goals and objectives for the portable XRF. This task is rarely undertaken, but is one of the most important. This tutorial will clearly communicate how a few hours spent by senior management at the beginning can ensure the success of a portable XRF project. Portable XRF orientation. As part of the portable XRF orientation section of the video series, we'll explain how carrying out an orientation survey before commencement of the program will allow you to assess the performance of the instrument's factory calibration on your samples, fine-tune this factory calibration if necessary to optimize performance on your project. We'll also explain the reasons why this might be necessary. Optimize test times. You don't want to test every sample for 60 seconds if you can achieve your data quality objectives doing 30-second tests. Select the appropriate sample containers. Will you use XRF sample cups, clip-lock sandwich bags? Will you test through the lab pulp paper sachets, or direct on the sample? These decisions have cost, time, and accuracy implications, so it's important you know what they are. And understand what sample preparation is needed, if any, to provide you the data quality you need to make decisions. Sample preparation and the effects of moisture are some of the most common questions we get from users. Quality assurance, quality control. Portable XRFs can blur the lines between geology and the laboratory, so any good program needs good QA/QC. We'll make some suggestions and show some examples in this video. Implementing the portable XRF program. This video will provide some tips for successful implementation of your portable XRF program. What works, what doesn't, where things can fall down. We'll use our experiences and the experiences of our customers to ensure you can do everything possible to make the best use of your portable XRF on your project. So that's what we have in store for you. We're really excited to undertake this project and we hope you will be too. Stay tuned for the next edition where we'll be discussing the importance of setting goals and objectives. Doesn't sound too exciting, but rest assured you'll be on the edge of your seat, I have no doubt. It may or may not be me talking to you next time. We'll try and draft in some other members of the International Mining Group to share their wisdom. Speaking of which, Aaron, where's Marcus?